So this is the brake assembly installed on Boeing 737-800 aircraft. There are four such brake assemblies installed on the aircraft. They are installed on the main landing gear. Two brake assemblies each side. And this is basically a hydraulically operated multiple piston. You can see the piston head here. There are six pistons, multiple pistons, and there is a disc. There are multiple discs. You can see the rotors. These are rotors. And you can see the colored one, there are discs. So these discs are having the friction pads, and basically when the hydraulic pressure is not applied, the rotors and stators are free to rotate. So this is installed on the axle of the main landing gear, over which the wheels are resting. So this is the for the wheel to engage. So the wheel is free to rotate. When we apply a brake, the hydraulic fluid is passed through this. We just saw the testing. Hydraulic fluid is passed through this, and the hydraulic fluid is applied to all the six pistons uniformly. Then all the pistons you see here, there are six. They extend and they apply pressure on this plate. This is called the pressure plate. Also, this pressure is subsequently transferred to every rotor, then stator. Like this, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 full stators, then to one sided. Also, this is a pressure plate and this is a torque tube. The whole pack will come together. Since the wheel is installed on the rotor and the stators are hold, so you will find the brakes are applied and the wheel will be stopped. So once the pressure is released, again the rotors and stators will be free to rotate. But again, you can see there is a different color combination. So the every color combination has got a significance, because this position, it got a weight, also the thickness. So we have to assemble this as per that. This is the design parameter. So once they are assembled that way, this portion is called the heat pack. This is where the energy is absorbed as and when the brakes are applied. So when the brakes are applied, so much of heat energy will be discharged. So the energy will be absorbed here. That's why what you see here is called the wear indicator pin. So the pin, now this is a fresh brake assembly with the fresh pads. That's why you are finding the pin length of this much. Now as the pad wears out, you will find this indicator pin will also be drawn through this. So the moment it comes flush here, that means our pads are worn out. So the brake assembly has to be removed from the aircraft and sent to our facility or the shop for further servicing. What we do, we remove all the worn out pads, we install new pads, also the rotor if it is worn out beyond the limit, we replace the rotor, then we replace all the seals and the adjusted tubes inside, then again, you saw that how we tested. Basically, the hydraulic test rig, the brake test rig used to simulate the hydraulic condition which is on the aircraft. Now here what you see on the horizontal, it is lying horizontally, but on the aircraft you will find it vertical.